Okay guys, I just popped a nice shape of a buckle, probably early 1800s, maybe a bit earlier. Looks iron to me, this one though, but it's very green, like the copper. So I don't know, could be copper underneath and just the iron pins making it look a bit rusty. I don't know, but it's a nice old button and happy days again, innit? Hopefully I'll be getting an Optin Impact to show you guys what it's all about very soon. And hopefully we can pull more cool finds up with that. Let you know all about it soon. Okay guys, those of you who are more up on your bag seals might recognise this design. It's not completely legible. Might clean up a bit when I get in, but some of you will probably know I've had similar ones. It's a bag seal anyway, a lead one. It's got the traces of writing on the back, but it's a bit worn. But it's our first bag seal, ain't it, Buster? Buster? Ow! Okay guys, just pop this big chunky weight. I know it's probably only a fish sinking weight or something. There's a minute possibility it's Rachel's trying to hide the worms. She's got a massive phobia to worms, Rachel, so you know you've got to take your hats off to her sticking it out with me being a metal detector, just always digging these worms up. Yeah, there's a minute possibility it could be something to do with the Romans, but chances are it's some sort of sinker. Busty. Bust. Buster. More shite, he said. More shite. Okay, guys, well, Buster's feet are icy cold and wet. So, my Rachel's going to walk him home. That's how cool this new ridge and furrow permission is. And safety, Ernie, darling. Catch you later. Bye. Dog ass. Okay, guys, another little find I'm happy with. Initially, I thought a little tiny buckle, but no. See it there? That's nice, isn't it? I know it's not gold. You can see a little tiny trace of the gild on it. On the D-loop. Might even be a little hallmark there. It might have been a snide one with a proper hallmark on. But it's nice, I'll take that. It's only little, I'll zoom out now so you can see, look. Happy Deus again. Happy Deus. With a 9-inch coil. Leisure Promotions. Yeah, you deus. Well, he's got some strange animals on this farm. He's only a baby, look. I have to reach right down to see this little boy. I think he's a muntjac deer. He's about the size of one anyway, and I'm going to put him in my glove box later because I know Rachel likes little ponies. There's one I've named Desmond. I've named that after you, Mr. Desmond. He's a solid looking geezer, he is. And yeah, I got that ridge and furrow there for now, but I'll get on this eventually. And there's a Roman villa site just behind me that belongs to another farm. I have to see how scheduled it is or not. And he's got a field over beyond the hedgerow once the crop comes up. So yeah, I think I'll name you Howard after my mate Hammy Howard, because I once seen a unicorn when I was out with Howard. You're lovely, aren't you, darling? I love you, you puff. I've only had 3 corns today, the shilling, and a blank, very worn old halfpence. See what this is. Oh, it's an old 10-pence piece. Well, at least it's a coin. Nearly finished now, anyway. Happy Deus. Another coin 3 feet away from the last one. Very similar signal. And yes, there you go. Somebody's been losing the 2 bob bits. Hey Bob, where's me blooming bits?
Okay guys, you always say swing to your car, swing till the very last. Nice tiny little flat button, little square looking shank on that. That'll easily be dateable. Shout out to my Aussie mate, Bazza. He of the button fixation. Only if they got shanks on though. Alright, Bazza, you little puff. There's a little naval button for you. Military and civil buttons, shout out to them on Facebook. I'll pop this in later, see how old it is.
I also found this nice Victoria Younghead 1859 shilling. Somehow I've deleted the footage though, but I've got a nice bit of silver.
Okay guys, I'm out again. And I've got my very own My Little Pony today. Look at him, he's gorgeous, isn't he? Don't know who this guy is, but he ain't little. There's another little pony. Everyone who's watched all my videos will know I'm a big fan of unicorns. I have to get them a home for Christmas. Yes, we know, Mr. Ed. We know. And you, Brownie. Brownie points. Okay, I just got the small pistol ball. This field is ridge and furrow, but most of the targets are deep, and the targets that aren't deep, I think it's the remains of some building that's been torn down or something, but it's scattered all over this field, so it's very frustrating, but there should be spits here. You really got to work for it though. Okay guys, just got this, hang on. And it's had that little piece attached to there. Don't know whether it's been a cufflink or something, but there's definitely a pattern on it. But it's one of them where it's very hard to tell until maybe get it cleaned in the house. But interesting anyway. Okay guys, just been getting a bit of lead in this area. So chipped away in the area where the lead's coming up. I've just got this pattern button. No shank on it, but I don't, or maybe the remains of one. Flat button, maybe 1700, so I'll see if we can sweep something out of this little area. Okay, well I've been here since 12 o'clock and it's tea time now, and I've just popped this little small spindle whirl, another old one I've had off here. And that really, apart from the spindle whirl and a button and that possible cufflink, is all I've had. There you go, I'll probably bundle this in with another video. And I'll detect off and see what I can get, if anything. Alright guys. Okay guys, I think it's about 3 musket balls I've had today. Just haven't really showed you any, but anyway, here's one with the sprue on. So that hasn't been used, but on the left is a really cool looking bullet. I would say that's early, that. It's got to be mid 1800s, I'd say. And I'll try and get a better ID on that bullet. Looks cool anyway. Okay guys, I just realised it's only just gone 3, so I am going to stay till the light fades, even though I'm struggling today. This could be possibly Tudor, possibly some sort of clothes fastener. If it is Tudor, it's probably the best find I've had today. And I'm going to grind a few other bits out for the last hour if I can. Very windy though, possible chance of rain, but there you go. Happy deus there, innit? Happy deus. It's got a scratchy, like, possible hammy signal. Now, I don't know what this is or what it's made of. The light's fading, but it's certainly thin enough to be a hammered. Possibly a worn copper one. Well, I'll try and clean it up and give you an update if it is anything. Okay, guys. Okay guys, the only coins I've had today is a 20 pence piece on the surface and a pound coin and a 5 pence. Definitely relic day today, and definitely a day to grind them out at the end. I've just found this mega cool key. Looks like it's made out of bronze. So that could be Roman. That could be a Roman key, that, or medieval. It's certainly not a modern key. Guarantee you that. It's amazing, I love it. Happy deus again, happy deus, late in the day. Little bit of a clean on it, and you can see it's like certainly not machine made, that. It's got to be either medieval or possibly Roman, something like that. It's got a really nice green tinge to it. Tells you it's old. Made up of that, guys. Worth me grinding it out today. Happy days. Okay, guys, it's only 4 o'clock, but we are in winter. Little piece of lead. It's a bag seal. I think it's my first bag seal off this one. Possibly my last find of the day. Okay, guys.